Today I'm going to be installing a C and C++ compiler for Windows. There's a Visual Studio Full Fat Edition, which is about 30 gigabytes. I don't want that much disk space being used, so I'll just go for the VS Code, which is cross-platform and much lighter weight, multi-purpose. I downloaded this from the Visual Studio Code website. There's a system installer and a user installer. Don't make the mistake I didn't get the user installer. You won't be able to share that installation between users. I can't tell which is which from the bottom of my browser window, so I open a Explorer and I find the one with the system extension. Accept the license agreement, the default directory, start menu folder, and the default traditional tasks, and go ahead with the install, which I sped up. Launch Visual Studio Code for the first time. Choose a light environment, which was the traditional default choice. It's only recently we've had dark. I find that quite jarring when you're coming from a web page which still maintains the tradition of a white background. Redefine your editing skills. Well, this is my first time and I'm quite productive with other IDEs, so I guess I should bring myself up to speed with this one. I open the playground, go through there, interactive session. Multicursor editing, that's what separates an IDE from a text editor, I'd say. So you make the same change on successive lines. IntelliSense, check that pops up something sensible in the context of where I'm working with the cursor. Line actions, adding a line above and below. I trust they work, it's not something I use, I just duplicate a line to save a copy buffer. Rename refactoring, book to wiki, that worked. Formatting, well, I know there's a shortcut key to get good formatting throughout the document. Code folding should be banned. Errors and warnings. I'm not getting the errors or warnings, so I'll save that for a live test later. Now snippets. It's like autocomplete on steroids. You have to learn aliases. It's not much use to me. It doesn't work at all for me here. But then I've never heard of it before. Okay, so I blaze around the menus, not doing anything. Now I look at the extensions pane. I browse through all the extensions, and there's a lot of multiple choice, but I choose C++, because that's what we're here for. Now back on the visualstudiocode.com page, I look at their installation getting started guide. Scroll up to the top, and they want me to install MinGW-w64 new for Windows. MinGW. They've got a link to the installer there, but it's out of date. What I want to do is click on the original source website, MSYS2, and that will show me a more up-to-date installer. MSYS are saying here that they'll be using the min.tty shell, which if you follow along my videos on Git Bash for Windows, you'll be up to speed on using already. Okay, so we've got the download rolling and it's just released a week or two ago. So it's way more up to date. Now that's completed. I just scroll through the screenshots and bring the installer to the foreground and resize it. Click next, accept the default. Notice it's not installing into program files. It's installed at the root of my C drive. So I can speed up this. Or I can follow along in the details pane. It's not very interesting. I would advise you not to bother. Installation finished. Run MSYS2 now. This will launch its suggested application, but it installs a bunch of other ones too, which you're going to need to know the difference between if you come to launch it yourself in future. And I'll save you the bother of researching which each of those do. The most up-to-date one you should be using on Windows 10 is the default I just launched for me. It's UCRT64.exe. We should default to using that. It's up-to-date. in terms of compatibility. Back on the VS Code how-to example installation page, it tells me the checks for GCC, GDB, Clang. Doesn't tell me that, but they're not installed yet. I'm just seeing what I got installed out of the box with MSYS. It says here I probably want to install some tools like the minimalist new for Windows GCC compiler, which with VS Start, we're going to need a compiler to compile C into anything other than fancy text. So they want me to run Pac-Man, and I did double check this on a couple of other sites, but it is Pac-Man we have to use from the MSYS environment. I think that's the Arch Linux package manager. It's what it tells us to use, so we use it, and that gets us a minimalist new for Windows, otherwise known as the GCC, saying it's built by MSYS, which means MSYS provides the libraries and binaries. Continuing to try to follow the how-to guides, there's two versions of this guide and a long Pac-Man command for installing a GDB debugger. So I copy that and then I search for it in the other version to make sure that both of these how-tos are on the same page. Paste that in and it's asking me what options I want. I refer back to the how-to. It tells me to take all of them, which means 1 gig of disk space. Speed that up 30 times. Then you'll see in the background the sample directory structure, which we're going to need in a minute. With that complete, I check GDB and it still isn't there. On the VSCode docs page, it tells me that I should be adding the MinGW-w64 path to mine. And I don't want to do that right now, so I'm just going to prefix it to the GDB instruction. And that hasn't worked. And that hasn't worked because I'm using Windows path separators and we're in a MinTTY Linux emulator. After replacing the path separators, I see I do have GDB, so it's time to get started with VS Code. I start a bash shell in the directory we created for this project. Our code isn't on the path, so I have to launch Explorer and copy-paste the path out of that into VS Code. Do I trust the authors? Well, I'm not always going to trust the authors of projects I dump into my project directory. I don't always trust them, but I trust them this time because it's from VS Code and I'm actually typing it in manually. Or pasting it. Let's talk through what that's doing. It's importing standard libraries to get you some text input and output. Vector is a data structure. String is a kind of data structure. It's also a bunch of functions pertaining to strings. Okay, I thought I was going to type it all in, but the initializer for the vector of strings is cumbersome to type. It initialized a vector, which is kind of an array or a list, depending on where you're coming from. So we've got a list of strings. And then we loop through them, and we output them to cout, which is standard out for C++. And we use the double less than signs to redirect, as you do in Linux. I click the run and debug arrow at the top. And it's asking whether I want to run as GCC or G++. Playing devil's advocate, I choose GCC to see if this project is simple enough to be run as GCC. It's saying it exited with a code 1, which is an error. And I search for the error and I can't see it, so I run it again. I get the same pop-up. And I see it's unable to find the reference to standard cout, which, as I was explaining earlier, is a C++ library for standard out, which I'm not going to have in C. I try and plow through all the configuration files in search of a way to correct this error, but I can't. The easiest way is going to be to delete it. And because the .vs code folder didn't exist before, I started my first run debug configuration. I figure it's going to be a safe option just to delete that and start again. and there was no state saved within the RAM of the IDE, so that gave me a clean start where I could choose a new run configuration, and that has worked. I don't see the output in the debug console window, immediately at least. I could scroll around a bit, but I just decided to run it again with a breakpoint on the cout just to make sure it does run. It wants me to choose the debugger here. I don't know why Windows one would be installed. I guess that's the default. Well, I don't know what it is, but I went for GDB because that's what we've just gone to the trouble to install. Leave the Windows one for another day. So our debug breakpoint triggered. It's highlighted. And there we see in the output that it did print out. And we can also see the call stack. And resume from the call stack. So I check out some more features of the IDE, and we've got code completion with the fancy icons. I wanted to see what we could do with what was built from Visual Studio Code, so I launched the Git Bash shell. Works all right there. While we're in this directory, you see there's 286k executable. I'll try it with command prompt. Get a notification of an error. And another. Try it in PowerShell. So there's no error. These other ways of running it, they're the wrong way. That's why it's giving us errors. They're saying it can't find it on the path to try the first way we already did, where there's no error, but also no output. That was unexpected behaviour, that our executable didn't run from standard Windows shells. So I'm going to attempt to find out why that was. I'll look at G++, see if it's on the path. It's not on the path. So I go into my environment variables and I see that they're set for another user, my personal user, who's not running this shell right now. That's why we're not on the path. So I have to take the variable out of that path and put it into the system-wide path. And now we see that G++ is on the path, where G++ is the MSYS folder location. In the Git Bash window, I show that G++ still isn't recognized as being on the path until I start a new shell with a bash command, which is essentially what I did by relaunching the command prompt for command prompt. I get a command prompt to take me to the folder of our project. And then I execute our executable and it works. Let's try it in PowerShell again. So I cd to the executable. And then run it. Yes, we have output. I'd still like to know how portable what we built is to other Windows systems that might not have MSYS installed. And I've been calling version wrong all this time. Needed to double hyphen prefix it.